Hey guys, in this video I'm going to go over this linear algebra problem. It says to use elementary row operations to reduce this augmented matrix to reduce row echelon form, and then the second part says to use the reduced row echelon form to solve this system of linear equations. So this is one of the first type of problems you're going to see in a linear algebra class. To solve a system of linear equations, you usually either use row echelon form or reduced row echelon form. So in this video we're going to do the latter. Just as a recap of what reduced row echelon form is, any matrix that is in reduced row echelon form is in row echelon form as part of the definition, and in addition to that, the leading coefficient of each non-zero row is equal to 1, which is called the pivot or the leading one, and each column containing a leading one must have 0 everywhere else. So I'm going to do an example of that in the first part. So we have the matrix 1, negative 1, 1, negative 1 is equal to 5, and then 1, 3, 5, 7 is equal to negative 3. So we want to have the 1 here is fine, and we want to get the second row to be 0 as the leading number. So the first operation that I'm going to do is I'm going to subtract R2 from R1, so the second row, the first row from the second row, and that's going to give me 1, negative 1, 1, negative 1, 5, so the same thing at the top, and then 0, 4, 4, 8, negative 8 on the second row. So that first operation already gives me row echelon form because we have the leading coefficient being 1, well, the leading coefficient being farther to the left on the first row than the second row. And now we just have to make this a 1 and get this to be 0. So to do that, I did 1/4 or 1/4 times R2, and that gives 1, negative 1, 1, negative 1, 5, 0, 1, 1, 2, negative 2. So now we have leading 1s on both rows, and now we just have to get rid of the negative 1, and I'm going to do that by adding row 1 and row 2 to get 1, 0, 2, 1 is equal to 3, and 0, 1, 1, 2 is equal to negative 2. So we're done with the first part, and as you can see, the first part helps us solve the system of linear equations in the second part, because if you look at the augmented matrix, it is the augmented matrix for this system. So if you look at the coefficients, 1, negative 1, 1, negative 1, that's the first row, equal to 5, and then for the second row, it's the same thing. So for systems of linear equations, you can either have one solution, infinite solutions, or no solution. So in this problem, we have two equations and four unknowns, and we have the row-reduced echelon form of the system of equations. So this is equivalent to saying x1 plus 0x2 plus 2x3 plus 1x4 is equal to 3 for the first row. And then 0x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus 2x4 is equal to negative 2. And the solution is just going to be written out what x1 is equal to. So x1 is going to be equal to 3 minus 2x3 minus x4. And we're going to do the same thing for x2. So that's going to be equal to negative 2 minus x3 minus 2x4. So just getting x2 and x1 on one side. And so we have two equations and four unknowns. So we're going to say that x3 can be anything. So x3 is arbitrary and x4 is arbitrary, because any values will satisfy that equation for x1 and x2. And so this problem has infinite solutions. And we are done with this problem.